He's one of our biggest culinary exports, but with COVID shuttering his restaurants, Curtis Stone had to adapt to survive. I was lucky enough to catch up with him and ask him how. Curtis Stone, it is so great to see you.
I ran up and put a jacket. I've got board shorts on the bottom half. But,
I love your work. You have created over the years so many incredible, delicious, memorable meals. What stands out for you? What do you think's been your best creation?
You know, I think whenever you push yourself, it's when you realise sometimes it can go terribly wrong, but for the most of the time, it's when it does the best. And I remember doing a roasted rack of lamb with a slow-cooked shoulder of lamb, and I remember talking to some of the event planners before, and they said, oh, no, you can't cook medium rare lamb for a room this big. And, you know, that's like waving a red flag in front of a bull. I was like, oh, yeah, we can and we will and it'll be perfect and it'll be just pink. And they said, are you sure? And we did. And I was so stressed about that decision. But I got a lot of compliments that night and I think it was probably my favourite menu.
What you, of course, always do, as you do in your restaurants in LA, is hero, as we say now as a verb, thanks to MasterChef, great Australian produce.
Yeah, of course, you know, getting your hands on beautiful Aussie produce and getting to showcase it, it's what I absolutely love. You know, we have a butcher shop here in Hollywood and we're constantly showing off our beautiful Aussie lamb and we get in beautiful, incredible Australian Wagyu from Blackmores. So, yeah, I'm very proud of what we produce back at home and it's nice to be able to show it off over here in the US.
How are you coping through the pandemic? You know, the hospitality business is one of the toughest to be in through this. How are you doing?
Oh, it's been brutal. It's horrible. You know, you just can't imagine it. And hundreds of employees that you sort of look in the eye and you're like, I'm going to do everything I can for you. But you know that it's very, very challenging. You know, you have businesses that require revenue to break even. It's that simple. And when the restaurants have been hit the way they have, they've just, you know, we've literally been forced to close. So we've done everything that we know how to do. We bought a refrigerated van and we started delivering food to people's homes. We opened a pop-up to do with picnics and now I'm about to open another one all about pies. So we're staying busy. And you know, one thing we said early on as a team was, let's not complain. Let's not stand in circles bitching and complaining about it. Let's just get on with it. Let's just work hard and do what we can. And when the situation changes, we'll do something different again.
What are you looking forward to most about life? Hopefully getting a bit more back to normal.
Look, I think it's been tough on the kids. There's been really nice parts about it too. You know, I haven't travelled at all in 6 months, which is so unlike me, in 9 months. It's been nice to be home for dinner. You know, as a chef who runs restaurants, you're always in your restaurants at night time. So to be home having those family moments, it's been really special and my kids have really enjoyed it. And I'm not sure about my wife, whether she's enjoyed it or not, to be honest. She might prefer that I was in the restaurants, but, you know, that's okay. Some nights she likes me being home. It's bittersweet. They're just sort of starting to talk of them going back to school now and then you start imagining them actually going off to school again and that's amazing for them and you want that for them. But at the same time, you're like, but it's been pretty cool getting to know everything that you do through your school day and, you know, you've got to see the good in it, I guess.
Thank you so much, Curtis. It's been lovely to see you. Stay safe and hopefully we'll see you face-to-face real soon.
So good chatting to you, Angela.